Well, a new year means a fresh slate, and for many of you, some New Year's resolutions.
Yeah, well, our good friend Les Szarka has some ideas for some resolutions financially and how you can kind of help your financial situation. Les, it's great to see you. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you, too. It's been a couple weeks since I've been on.
It's been a little while, yeah.
Looking awake?
I took some time off. I took some time off to recharge the batteries.
Good for you. We all need to do that, no doubt. Yeah. All right, so talk about, a lot of people have these goals, and we call them New Year's resolutions. Might be better to call them goals. So talk about that. Right. What are some ideas that you might have for our viewers, especially now? It's a tough financial time anyway.
Right. Well, there was a lot of takeaway lessons, I think, from last year. And I think the first takeaway is you've got to make sure you've got an emergency stash of money somewhere. You know, so if something does happen, you know, that you're not having to hit credit cards, you're not having to cash in 401ks, this thing like that. So make that one of those priorities for this year, is make sure that you've got enough in emergency cash. And typically we recommend having at least, you know, 6 months worth of fixed expenses. That way, if something does happen, you know, let's say, you know, we have another major shutdown or you get unemployed or something, you know, that you've got money that you can fall back on to pay bills. The other suggestions that I have are a little bit more esoteric, if you will. One of the things I did notice through last year is that, you know, we always stress for folks to have a long-term financial plan, you know, what their goals are and how you intend on getting there. And those folks that have those long-term plans did well psychologically much better than those that didn't going through last year, which was obviously very tumultuous. And, you know, and this year, frankly, it may also be very, very volatile. So if you don't have that long-term plan, you know, sit down, figure out what are the goals, how are you going to get there, and then by all means have a plan B. Because I don't know about you, but most of the, you know, if I look back on my lifetime, very rarely does my plan A work out exactly the way I thought it was going to be. So having that plan B is very, very critical. The other thing I would suggest is just be sure that you're prepared to move quickly. So if something does change, I'm not talking about changing the long-term plan. I'm talking about it if the circumstances change. You want to be able to make sure you can shift courses quickly. One of the things we did notice is that, you know, people waited too long. You know, they kind of just sat on it and didn't, you know, look at the situation and say, okay, I need to make some changes now. Having said that, though, what I would suggest very strongly is make sure that they're not emotional changes. So you're not changing it because of an emotion, because you're afraid or greedy or whatever. It's because it's a logical decision. So again, be prepared to make a change, but make sure you're thinking it through. And I always tell clients, give yourself that 24-hour timeout before you make a major decision. Figure out what you want to do, but then sit on it, because typically nothing major is going to change in 24 hours. The other thing I would just mention, having gone through last year, and I know I get a lot of questions from people all the time, is, you know, I heard this, I read this, what do you think? Develop a trusted source of financial income for yourself, or financial advice. Because if you're getting your financial advice from the general media, the national media, good luck. Because it's going to have a slant, it's going to have a bias to it, and it's not going to necessarily reflect what's actually happening. And I can tell you firsthand, having observed what was said on the national media going through last year, a lot of us in the profession just scratched our heads saying, what the heck were they thinking saying that?
Right.
So develop this trusted source of financial information that you can rely on and say, okay, now I can go back and logically make a decision.
Yeah, trust those local sources like us and like you, Les.
Absolutely.
I like leaning on local folks because they can help you take the emotion out of those big financial decisions. We're out of time. We apologize. Thanks so much for joining us as always, Les. Good to see you. You look healthy and happy. And here's to a great 2021 to you, Les. Now, if you have financial questions or need more information on Szarka Financial Services, you can head to our website, foxaid.com, and click on Scene on TV.